Last year, Americans spent over $50 billion on weight loss drugs like Ozempic and Wegovy. Their popularity and their price are having effects throughout the economy. PBS News Hour special correspondent and Washington Post columnist Catherine Rampell has the story.
I would have come right here.
At the grocery store, Taryn Mitchell always made a beeline to the cookies.
Biscoff would have gotten me every time.
Mitchell has long struggled with her weight.
This says that a serving size is 4 cookies. I would not have been able to stop at 4 cookies. I would have had 4 cookies, and then the next hour I would be hearing them call me. The noise would be so loud that I would have to eat all the cookies because they just can't be there. They miss me when they're in the pantry. They need me.
Her food noise was muted thanks to a new class of drugs called GLP-1s, such as Ozempic, Wegovy, and Zepbound. They were first made to treat diabetes. After being approved for weight loss, prescriptions have surged. About 1 in 8 U.S. adults has now taken these meds. The name brand versions cost about $1,000 without insurance.
It changes the way my brain responds to the hunger, and it changes the way my brain tells me that I am hungry, right? So your stomach still rumbles a little bit, but it is not a voracious monster in there that's, feed me, Seymour. It is not that.
She'd tried everything.
I have tried fasting. I have tried so many different weight loss medications. 2 rounds of surgery, you name it, I have tried it.
Mitchell started Wegovy last summer. It's transformed not only her shape, but her spending.
How much money do you think you're saving on groceries?
I would probably say I'm saving about $100 a month.
That's not uncommon.
It's about 20% decline in monthly spend on groceries for a one-person household.
We see the biggest decline.
Leo Feller is chief economist at research firm Numerator. He's been following how GLP-1 meds are changing spending habits.
Categories where we see the greatest increases in consumption.
He tracks receipts for about 18,000 households who volunteer that at least one member has taken these drugs.
A little bit over half are using them for diabetes. And that means a little bit under half are using them for weight loss.
For those taking the drugs to lose weight,
you see bigger declines in things like chips and things like candy and things like ice cream, sugary sodas.
Wurro.
As online pharmacies make versions of these drugs more widely available, snack food makers have begun worrying about their bottom lines. Walmart's U.S. CEO said that shoppers on GLP-1s are buying less food.
Do you see any impact of the
Hershey's Michelle Buck told CNBC her firm is watching the situation.
We are closely monitoring it, but we believe we can adapt.
In fact, Nestle just announced a new line of foods intended for GLP-1 users. There's also evidence that these meds may decrease other addictive behaviors like drinking, smoking, and drug use.
On spirits consumption outside of the holidays, we saw an effect, and we saw a little bit of an effect on wine and beer.
Mitchell buys less wine and Jack Daniels.
When was the last time you saw the Gentleman Jack?
Christmas.
Oh, wow. Whereas in the before times?
Oh, he and I were very well acquainted.
Okay.
Mitchell's obesity is now in remission.
You started this journey not out of vanity, not because you were unhappy with how you looked. You did it for health reasons, correct?
Absolutely. I don't want to be sick. And both my parents had dementia, Alzheimer's. I think there are 7 women in my family that have been stricken with breast cancer. These are things that have a causal link to obesity. We don't know, of course, you know, what is actually causing them, but the link is there.
There are over 200 diseases that have been connected to obesity.
Jessica Bartfield, an obesity medicine specialist, is Mitchell's doctor.
Things like type 2 diabetes, high blood pressure, cardiovascular disease, strokes, osteoarthritis, neoplasms or cancers.
Mitchell says her overall health has improved. She no longer has diabetes, for example.
I'm on Wegovy for the rest of my life, but I can show you an entire medicine cabinet full of medications that I no longer have to take.
Feller was so struck by his data that he himself recently began using a GLP-1 and has lost 25 pounds of COVID weight.
There is a long-term health benefit, right? My 70-year-old self is going to be thanking me. If people are healthier, they might live longer lives. They might have less morbidity later on in their lives.
The drugs are pricey. Some patients may have to take them for the rest of their lives. And we don't yet know all of the long-term effects.
Tight squeeze.
Right now, they don't pay for themselves in reduced healthcare spending, but someday they might, if insurers and payers get a discount.
We've measured the additional costs that come from having these prescription drugs against the savings you get from reduced cardiovascular outcomes and things like that. Right now, it looks like at something like a 50% discount on the cost of the drugs, you would actually be saving the healthcare system money as a result of these treatments.
Health economist Michael Dickstein says the drugs might have effects on the labor force, too.
There's an effect on your productivity at work, the years in which you work.
That's certainly been true for Mitchell.
I have more energy. I picked up a little summer job at the baseball field. Just, I'm trying new things and I am enjoying it.
Could you have taken the summer job before you had lost all this weight?
No, I would just be too tired, to be quite honest.
All this affects government spending too, on things like Social Security and Medicare. But it can cut both ways.
You might have additional years working. That's something to compute. You also have additional years of life after you retire, which means the pensions are going to have to pay out for a longer period.
The drugs alone could lead Medicare spending to skyrocket, especially as they get approved for more health issues.
Eli Lilly's drug is under investigation for sleep apnea. Wegovy itself is under investigation for Alzheimer's disease. So at the point at which that gets approved, assuming it does, that's going to be another fraction of the population within Medicare that would be eligible.
So we're talking billions of dollars more in spending per year just on Medicare.
That's right.
Given the high upfront costs, U.S. states and private insurers are struggling with whether to cover them.
Individuals switch employers quite often. In the U.S., that means sometimes you switch your insurance provider. It doesn't always make sense for them to pay for this treatment today because the cost savings might go to a different insurer or to the Medicare program.
Injection once a week.
Bart Field sees it here in North Carolina. The state employee health plan recently stopped covering GLP-1 drugs for weight loss due to cost.
This can be a barrier, and it can be frustrating, particularly when you think that that is the best treatment for a patient.
Another barrier, overflowing demand for the drugs, has meant that patients like Mitchell have faced shortages.
I didn't start the medication when it was first prescribed because I couldn't find it at any pharmacy. We did horseback riding on the beach.
Even if Mitchell's cutting back on groceries, she has found herself spending money on other activities, like horseback riding with her daughters.
It was amazing, to be quite honest. I would have never thought to go horseback riding on the beach.
Because?
You're over 200 pounds, you know, you don't want to hurt the horse. I know that doesn't sound logical, but these are the things that you think. I would take the girls horseback riding and I would watch them because I always want my children to have these experiences. But I never thought that I would be part of the experience.
And this is the coolest.
Something you can't put a price on. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Catherine Rampell in Greensboro, North Carolina.